Hi everyone, this is Dom and I'm here with Dell at CES where we have yet another new XPS 13. Now what's interesting about this one is it takes a lot of cues from the XPS 13 2-in-1 that was released at Computex in 2019. Now whack when I saw that 2-in-1, I fell in love. And it made so many great little quality of life changes that I said that was the first time the 2-in-1 convertible XPS 13 was actually better than the clamshell model, which I never would have expected to say. So I'm really pleased to now see the new regular XPS 13 and see all those great touches are here without the one flaw that I had with the 2-in-1 to basically say, right, well, the regular 13 has retaken its crown. This is now the best XPS laptop again. And that probably means it's pretty much the best 13-inch ultrabook around. The big change we'll see straight out of the gate is it's a 1610 panel rather than the 1609 that all the previous XPS 13s had. So yeah, the 1610 came in with the 2-in-1. It's here, that means we used to have, in fact, we've got the previous gen regular 13 here. You see we've got this big fat bottom bezel with the Dell logo right in the middle. And if we put them side by side, that is all gone. So that's just free screen space you're getting that you never had before. So it's a little bit more vertical real estate, which is what I love in a laptop screen. Gives you a bit more workspace. Looks really beautiful. It's the same kind of bright panel from the 2-in-1, 500 nits. You get it in full HD, or you can get it, well, full HD plus, or in 4K. There's Dolby Vision HDR on either screens. There's a touchscreen option, all that standard XPS stuff that you know and love. Top bezel, still super thin. Webcam, still there, thankfully, not at the bottom. It's just a regular webcam. There's no IR camera, so no Windows Hello. There's just not the space to fit it in. But simple, straightforward webcam. Fingerprint scanner is the biometrics. Once again, following the 2-in-1, that's now in the power button. So it's built into the keyboard rather than sitting to the side of it. That's because, as we can see, keyboard now runs right to the edges of the body. Again, a little lesson that came from the 2-in-1, whereas the previous standard XPS 13 had that little bit of extra space here. So that space means the keys are now bigger. So it's just every single keycap is a little bit larger. The font's actually changed for the nicer. It just looks a bit slicker. The whole keyboard feels nicer. But more importantly, what it hasn't taken is the maglev keyboard from the 2-in-1. Now that was the second gen maglev. It was a lot better than the first gen, but it was still loud. I didn't like the feel of it. It was close, but not quite right. This is back to a sort of standard rubber dome keycap setup. There's 1 millimeter travel, so it's still short travel, but it feels really good to type on. It's a lot quieter than the 2-in-1. Great keyboard all round. The trackpad also, as you can see, nice and big, really spacious, really simple, really clear. Feels nice to use, pretty responsive. What else? There's the cooling system for the 2-in-1. The dual fan, copper pipe like cooling setup is here. So this thing should be able to run fast and stay relatively cool. It's got the latest 10th gen Ice Lake processors. Just goes up to 4 cores, not like the 6-core XPS 13 we saw come out in late 2019. But then you can go up to 32 gig of RAM. There's loads of different storage options, and the storage is not soldered on, so it is upgradable as well. Prices are gonna start at $999. I don't know about pounds yet. Obviously, that won't get you everything. That would get you an i3, I think 4 gig of RAM and 128 gig storage, and the full HD plus screen. So if you wanna throw in 4K, if you wanna throw in touch, if you wanna up the storage, go up to an i7, or whatever, prices are going to climb, obviously, but that's what you get with an XPS. But still, we're basically the same pricing as last time. Oh, and battery's the same too, exact same battery capacity as last time, 52 watt hours, I think. So it should get you like 19 hours of runtime, which I think for like video and active use is gonna be more like 13, 14. That's still really, really solid. But this basically is the best the XPS 13 has been yet. It takes everything that the 2-in-1 did right, crams it back into the regular, lovely clamshell form, and yeah, I want one. All right, like and subscribe. Stay tuned for the rest of our CES coverage rolling out across the week. Cheers.